Here is a question to all the Toastmasters. How many of you here do not have your CC or CL manuals filled up to date? Please raise your hands. Yeah, even I don't have my manuals. Now here is a question to all the guests. How many of you are interested in Toastmasters but didn't yet join the club? Please raise your hands. Okay. Wondering why I am asking these questions? Because filling our manuals or joining Toastmasters are some of the activities that we tend to put off. We know they are important, but still, we delay them. This fact intrigued me, and I thought, let me find out a reason why we tend to postpone certain activities. Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear friends, let me share with you few interesting observations. What are the key reasons why we tend to procrastinate? Let's go one by one. Let's see the first one. When the task ahead is boring, such as filling your timesheets or doing those mandatory certifications. I hope most of you here would agree that these are the activities which are very boring, but mandatory. Generally, we don't do them at the first instance. And the result is our mailbox gets flooded with tons of reminder mails. And to understand the extent to which we postpone such activity, you have to know that there are certain roles created just to do follow up on certain activities. And those roles are nothing but our manager roles. So what do we gain by postponing such activities? Nothing, except that we are giving our work to our manager. In fact, if it takes just 10 minutes to complete the activity, over a period of time, it will take around half an hour to go through all the reminder mails and then do a shift delete. And instead of doing this, instead of adding such tasks to our to-do list and then burdening our brain to remember all such activities, it is better to do them immediately. So the best way to get rid of any task which we can't escape is to do them immediately. Do it now. Now let's see the second reason. We postpone stuff because we think there is a lot of time in front of us. Let's say you want to start a new business, or you want to go for higher education, or you want to improve your communication skills. Most of the times we fail to act upon our dreams because we think we have whole life in front of us, then why to hurry? Even though we are genuinely interested, we wait for the perfect moment to start up the task. We will start working on our dreams when we have less work in our project, or when our family problems are solved, or when our life becomes a bit stable. But how many years do you think you are going to live? Due to many uncertain conditions like pollution, ill-maintained infrastructure, due to global warming or due to natural calamities, our lifespan is shortened. Further, as years pass by, we'll get busy both personally and professionally. So whatever way we see, life becomes complicated and uncertain with each passing day. So the best time to give wings to our dreams is to do it now. Start working on your dreams now so that you will see you will be on your way to success. So as we have seen, we have talked about two reasons why we tend to procrastinate. One is when the task is boring, or when we think that there is whole life in front of us. Now let's see the third reason. The third one is when we doubt our abilities. Let's say that you want to learn a new project, a new software, or you want to prepare for an exam, or you want to write a speech. Then what do? We mostly postpone that activity, because we think that we don't have the ability to do that task. Let's say you want to write a speech. We think about that speech for days or even for months to get that perfect idea. And when we think that we didn't get any suitable topic, we just put it off. In fact, the best way to start working on your speech is to start drafting your thoughts, and eventually you will see that you have a lot of material to work upon. And similarly, if you want to prepare for an exam, don't doubt your capabilities. You can learn anything and everything just by putting in extra hours. practice makes perfect. And that practice you will get only when you start off. So whenever you see yourself postponing any activity because you are uncertain whether you can do it or not, then start off immediately. Because with that at least you will get a lot of time to work on that particular activity. Now let's recap what we have learned today. There are three reasons for procrastination. One is when the task ahead is boring. So do it now, because that's the only way to get rid of it. And second one, when we think we have a lot of time in front of us. Do it now, because tomorrow is uncertain. And third one, when we doubt our abilities. Do it now, because practice makes a man perfect. So my dear Toastmasters, now that we don't have any excuses to procrastinate, let's get our CC or CL manuals filled up immediately after the meet, even though the task is boring. And also, my dear guests, join Toastmasters today, because life is too short to contemplate.